Hey guys, as you saw in the previous video, we implemented a code in C++. Now we are going to sign up in the Codeforces platform and solve problems in there. So do everything that I'm gonna do with me, and then after that, you're ready to be a competitive programmer. Yeah, so we now load the Codeforces webpage. Once it is loaded, I will click on register. And well, here it needs a handle, an email, and password. Well, for the email, I'm going to use temp mail, but I don't recommend you to doing this. It's better if you just use your own email, but because here I'm just making this account for educational purpose, and I'm just making this account to explain these things for you, I'm just using temp mail because I don't want to use one of my emails for this. So I will just use a temporary email for signing up in Codeforces. So I can just use this email, and my handle can be, I don't know, educational accounts. Let me make key small as well. And password can be something. Okay guys, so as you put your password, then you receive this message and you should look at your email. You have to receive an email from Codeforces at this point. So we need to wait for that email. Okay, so we received the email. We need to confirm our accounts. We open this link and yes, your account is successfully created. Okay, so when you want to solve a problem from Codeforces, you can just come to this problem search. And you will see a huge amount of problems in here that you can solve them. So now I want to solve one of them with you. And you can solve your very first problem in the Codeforces platform. Moreover, Codeforces has a contest page. Well, in this part of the website, you will see a lot of contests. For example, there is a contest tomorrow and many other contests after that, and you can participate in them and compete with other competitive programmers and solve algorithmic challenges and problems, and at the end of that you receive some rating. Well, here my rating is 0, I'm unrated, and my contributions is 0, I'm friend of the 0 users, because I recently made this account and I haven't done anything with it. But when you participate in accounts, for example, your account will be like this, like Cheyenne in here, that you can see that your account will be rated, your rating will be shown here, and you have a color based on your rating, and here you can see the chart of your growth. So, but in this account, my account is unrated and there's nothing. But when you compete in contests, your accounts will become rated. So let's start with solving a problem from here. I will start with problem 4A. I will change here to 4A watermelon. So let's solve this problem together. I put the link of this problem in the description below. Okay guys, so I will explain to you that what this problem wants from you in the tablets. Well, this problem is saying that you are given a number W, which is from 1 to 100. And it says that assume that you have a watermelon of weight W. And you want to divide it between two boys. Each of these boys want to have some part of watermelon that its weight is an even number. So each of the boys wants some part of the watermelon so that the weight of each one of them is an even number. So obviously W1 plus W2 should be equal to W. So you want to divide W in two numbers such that each of them are even and the sum of those two numbers is equal to W, definitely. Well, you have to say that, is it possible or not? Well, in order to solve this problem, I say this, that first, W should be even. Why W should be even? Well, the point is, if W is not even, then it cannot be sum of two even numbers. Because we know that W1 should be even, and also W2 should be even. And W is equal to sum of W1 and W2. Therefore, W is definitely an even number as well. Okay. And moreover, W cannot be 2. Because if it is 2, the only way to divide it is to give one of the boys 1 and the other boy 1 as well. But these numbers are not even. So W should be greater than 2. But any other number, any other W that you have, and which is an even number greater than 2, you can give W minus 2 to one of the boys and 2 to the other boy. And this way it is gonna be possible. So the answer to this problem is that if W is even and it is greater than the 2, then we can say that the answer is yes. Otherwise, the answer is no. So we have to implement it. Okay, so let's start implementing this. Let's clear the code that we implemented before. Here we need to have a number W. So we first see in W, and then we have to see that if it is an even number or an odd number, and it is greater than 2 or less than 2. Next, I will write this code, if W modulo 2. Well, this percentage sign that you see in here is just used for calculating the modulo. When you want to see that what is the remainder of W by 2, then you can just write this W modulo 2. If you want to find the remainder of A by B, you should write A modulo B. Okay, so I'm just saying it here. And if you want to write the comment in your code, it's just enough to write 2 backslash. And by using 2 backslash, everything in that line will not be executed. It is just the comments. This line of code has no effect on your code. You can write anything in here. Say, hi, I'm Cheyenne. So this is a comment. This is not going to do anything. So if you want to find the remainder, this is the remainder of A after division by B. So you say that if W divided by 2 is 0, then you can say that your number is even. If it is not 0, if it is equal to 1, then your number is odd. So here we see that we have an if here. If W modulo 2 is equal to 0, what does it do? It is exactly as you say it. It's if something happened, do this. Okay, so it's just saying that if this happens, do this. But here I can say that if W was greater than 2, I should see out, yes. Okay. So let me see here, yeah. So I should write yes. If W was equal to 2, I should see out no. And then here I should write that if W divided by 2 was 1, and then I say that if W modulo 2 was 1, then I should see out no as well. So let's run it and see what happens. Is it working correctly or not? Let's first give 8 to it as the sample example in here. Is 8, it should give us yes, and this is gives us yes. So if I give it 5 to it, it should give us no, and it gives us no. And if I give 2 to it, it gives us no. So this code is performing well. So when we want to submit it and see if it is working correctly or not, we can just copy this code. And here you can use the submit option and use your language. Our language, for your language, you can use just G++20. This is C++. This is a compiler of C++. You can paste your code in here and then click submit. And when you do this, your code will be submitted and you can see the verdict here. We see that the verdict here is accepted. So our code is working properly. And we solved this problem. So you solved your first problem from the Codeforces platform. In the next video, I'll be talking about how you can optimize this code and write it in a more professional way. So I invite you to watch the next video and see how we can make this code better.